Hello and welcome in my Windows 7 laptop. What we're gonna do in this video is create a light installer from my Windows 7 Professional so it can be installed on an older PC. These things are not being created so much anymore because everyone these days have, you know, these powerful PCs that can run everything just fine. But this is just for a special PC of mine, an older laptop, that I would love to give a light version of Windows 7. We're gonna do this with software from Dino Nuhi. It's called V-Lite. V-Lite was specially created to lighten down the installer of Windows Vista. However, later when we got Windows 7, we found out that it also worked on Windows 7. Okay, so how to get started? Well, you will need your ISO file. I created one from my DVD with Power ISO, okay? And up here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open it. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to my 7-zip, and then I'm gonna say extract to Windows 7 32-bit Professional x86. So we're gonna first unpack. And the first time, well, let me first tell you about V-Lite. You will need two files, okay? You will need V-Lite 1.1. I kept it for many years. I never let go of it. I still had it. V-Lite 1.1. Install it, and after that, you install the latest version, the updated version 1.2, on top of it, okay? Here you can see it. You first install V-Lite 1.1 and then you install V-Lite 1.2. If you don't do it this way, it's not gonna work. You're gonna have a problem, okay? And when you start up V-Lite, you're gonna get a little box here, and then you must hit install WinFilter, okay? Don't forget about this, it's very important. I think the window will block you from continuing if you don't click the install WinFilter. Alright, so remember that this is for educational purposes and not to pirate anything. So you need your own DVD with Power ISO. You can, from your DVD, create the ISO file, or maybe with your serial number you can go to Microsoft.com and up there download the ISO that you have your registration number for. Okay, so if you have a registration number of Windows, go to Microsoft, go to downloads, you know, select Windows 7 that you want to download Windows 7. Microsoft will ask you the key of your installation. Maybe it's under at your laptop or somewhere. Just find it, put in that number, and you will get the download from Microsoft. Okay, so now we are unpacking these files. And I think we are already unpacked, I think. Let me see. Windows 7 Professional, etc. I do this all on my C drive. Okay? So, you can set that on any other drive that you wish, but I put it on my C drive. So now we're gonna hit Browse. Select where you have the Windows Vista or even Windows 7 installation files unpacked. Okay, so we're gonna go to our C drive, and we had the folder up here, not icon pack, this one. We select it and we say okay. So now this process might take a little, I'm not gonna pause the video because I'm doing this with Camtasia. Up here we're gonna select the version that we're gonna do. Mine is professional, so you can do ultimate, home premium, home basic, etc. Okay, select the right version, the one that your ISO represents, otherwise it won't work. Very important. As you can see, we're doing this. This is the architecture is 32-bit. I especially went for 32-bit because I already told you I want to create a light version and not some version that will run on some high-end PC. So there you see that we selected the folder, everything is loaded. We can now hit next. I'm gonna maximize the screen so you can see it even better. Okay, so here we are at task. What do we want? Integration. You want to integrate drivers, language packs, etc. Well, I don't have to add any driver because in fact that laptop, all the drivers will be fault from that laptop. And if not, I do have the drivers of that laptop. So I'm not gonna install no drivers, because if I'm gonna install drivers, then it's gonna be specific for one device. Okay, and in fact I just want to try a test version to see if it's possible what I want to do and if the system will boot. It's an old Celeron, so in fact it should not have no issues. The processor should be just fine with everything. So up here you can select to add stuff. What you're gonna do, I'm gonna remove components, I want tweaks, I want the unattended setup, and I want to create a bootable CD or ISO. Okay, and up here integration, I'm not gonna, in fact, yeah, I don't want to integrate, only tech drives will be installed, others will be available in the driver cache, so when you connect that hardware it will be recognized. You see that? So that is kind of cool, eh? Only detected drivers will be installed. So that means if you're gonna, for instance, add drivers to it, it will not affect a system that you want to run this onto that does not contain that hardware. So that is very smart. Okay, so thumbs up for that, Mr. Dino. Well thought. Dino is like, hey, you had to say that so many years ago, but I did. So we're not gonna integrate anything, okay? All right? I don't feel like integrating anything. Let's go next. So what are the functionalities that you would love to keep? Windows Update, of course. Well, Windows Update might not work, eh? Because if we're gonna remove certain parts out of the systems, then yeah. Scanners and cameras. Do you want to use your scanner and camera? I don't think so. Recommended. Internet Explorer, yeah. We don't have anything else. Internet Information Services. File and printer sharing, I don't need that. Aeroglass, so it will look nice. System Restore. We can leave out of the system. But effect, yeah, we can leave it out of the system. But if something goes wrong, you will not be able to restore. So this is not for, how you say that, for rookies. This is not for noobs, in fact, I think. Because if you must go do a system, I don't think you should use this system as your... Well, I don't know. Depends on what kind of computer you have. You could use it as your only system. But, yeah, only if your system cannot run the full version. Okay? Only then. Otherwise, it makes no sense. Alrighty? So, I'm not gonna put System Restore. you could put system restore whenever you want. And in fact, yeah, Windows Update, no. Because if I'm gonna install Windows Update, then I might run into errors, but we could, let's just install Windows Update. And we said okay. So now you see many things, okay? Really go get yourself something to drink. Don't just stress. Open all these, because we will have to go through them all. Okay. First of all, accessibility. Would you like to keep that? If you're having some form of disability, how you say that? If you're not seeing too good, or you need, yeah, I don't think that you should remove this, but I'm gonna remove it. Okay, it saves us a whole lot, as you can see, 15 megabytes. Character maps, I would not touch that. Disk cleanup, I would leave that. Games, well, we could remove that. That's 100 megabytes. Let's remove games. Mobility center puts the most frequently used mobile PC settings in a single ease to find location. Yeah, mobile PC. Yeah, we don't need that. Notepad, of course we need it. Paint is only 1 megabyte. Sniping tool, I want to keep. Speech support, that's really big. It's almost 500 megabytes, so let's just remove speech support. Okay, and 1 second, let me see. Okay, no big deal. So we saved ourselves now more than 600 megabytes already. Okay, system information, I would not remove that. Welcome center, we could remove. Windows sidebar and gadgets, 12 megabytes, we could remove that. WordPad, I would not remove. Eh? Drivers, very important. Diva server, I'm not gonna use that. Modems, we're not using modems anymore. Printers, I'm not gonna use any printer. So this system that I'm creating will need its own printer drivers, probably. Okay, if you're gonna install, maybe printers will not even work on this system, but I don't care about that. Qlogic fiber channel adapter, I don't know what that is. I'm gonna leave it. Scanners, I'm not gonna scan anything. Storage controllers, I would not touch that. TV tuners, if you're gonna install some TV card or something, you should not remove that or find the one that you want to keep, but I'm gonna delete them all. It's another 17 megabytes. Okie doke. Hardware support. Dynamic volume manager. Dynamic disks were first introduced with blah blah blah. It provides features that basics just dot nuts. Damn, I can't read it. Ability to create volumes that span needed for drive image XML and Windows backup. I'm gonna keep it. Fax support, I don't want a fax. Okay, I'm not a faxer. 23 megabytes. These days we use email. FireWire 1394 support. Yeah, it's so small, I'm gonna leave it. Floppy disk support, I'm gonna leave because I have a floppy disk in this. It's unbelievable. I have a laptop here. i3, wait, hold on, where's the floppy? Oh no. No, you don't have A drive. That was SD card drive. Okay, no. We can, yeah, floppy disk support, let me think. If we're gonna install this on an old, yeah, who's using floppy disk? Burk, come up now, man. Infrared support, we're gonna leave that. Internet small computer interface, system interface. Connecting search device over network using TCP IP. This will not remove the NAS support. Okay, let's remove this. Microsoft Multipad provides the ability to use more than one physical pad to access a storage device. I'm not gonna remove that. Modem support. We don't need it. We connect to LAN or Wi-Fi. Printer support. We don't need it. Smart cards. I think you want to keep your smart cards. This will remove smart card services as well. If you use some sort of smart card device in your computer, then do not select this for removal. We're not gonna use that. TV support. Needed for for media center. It's not needed. I don't want it. Windows hot start. We can keep that. Windows image acquisition. Provides image acquisition services for scanners and camera. I'm going to use a scanner or camera. No, I'm not going to use any of that. Windows portable devices. Enables applications like Windows Media Player and Image Import Wizard to transfer and synchronize content using removable mesh storage devices. Will not break USB storage. It will not break. Will not break USB storage. Okay, so it's a sort of USB player for that. Yeah, we can remove it. WLAN support we must keep. Okay. Xbox 360 controller, not using that. Languages, I'm gonna remove, in fact, all languages here. Yeah? And I'm gonna remove all the languages. In fact, I'm gonna remove them all. It's a whole lot of megabytes. Languages is 1000 megabytes. It's a gigabyte. Let's remove languages, okay? Let's do ourselves a favor. Just look for your language. If you're from Romania or from India, you know, select all and only delete all, but only keep your language, whatever you're using. This, by the way, this light DVD, I will not be able to share. So this is just for me. If you want to create this, you must create it yourself. So please, don't ask me for link and things like that. Don't be lazy. Go do it yourself. Okay, it's very important that you learn how to do it. Multimedia, Intel Ideo. It's a video codec that we're not using anymore. Media Center is 326 megabytes. We're not using Media Center. We have Kodi these days. Media Meta Handler, I'm gonna keep that. Music and video samples, another 400 megabytes. I'm gonna delete that. Photo Metadata Handler, I'm gonna keep that. Sample pictures, I'm gonna remove. Screensavers, 32 megabytes, I'm gonna remove. Shell event sounds is only 8 megabytes, but I like these sounds. They bring life to the computer, you know? So these sounds, I'm not gonna remove them. Slideshow, 5 megabytes. Techno enables laptop manufacturers to include a secondary or auxiliary display in future laptop designs. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that. Sound recorder, yeah, in fact, this is the most useless sound recorder ever, but it's so small, I'm gonna keep it. Windows codecs, media codecs, you know, if you're gonna remove this, then I found out you run into problems. I found that out in the past, so you must keep that. And Windows Media Player, yeah, needed for Media Center, but in fact, if you're gonna remove this, you won't have no media player. But we have, of course, K-Lite Mega Codec Pack with the old-fashioned media player in it, because this is still 75 megabyte. So let's remove it. Okay, we're gonna remove the media player because we're not gonna use the media center. Okay, connect to a projector. I wanna keep that. Some people, you know, they want to do some reading with a thing with their old laptop, and yeah, distributed file system, DFS, I'm gonna keep. printer sharing server. Ja, file and print, file and printer sharing server. Yeah, no, I don't want it. Link layer, topology, discovery. I don't even know what it is. Network and sharing center. Used to troubleshoot network connectivity issues. Ah, okay, this is like node if removed, it will be replaced with the network connection and control panel, so you will have access to your connections. To access new connection, setup, stop window. Okay, but how much megabyte is it? Only 4. Yeah, let's remove it. Remote desktop, I'm gonna remove that. I never liked it. Remote desktop client, I'm also gonna remove. RIP listener, remote access service IP routing information protocol, gonna leave that. Simple network management protocol, I'm not gonna touch that. Use in network management systems to monitor network attached devices for conditions that, oh yeah, no, we can remove this. Simple TCP, I'm not gonna touch that. Telnet server, server for the terminal emulation program, TCP IP networks, not gonna touch that. Windows collaboration, peer-to-peer infrastructure to support serverless presence, app invite contacts and people near me, this will not affect. Okay, then we're gonna remove it. And Windows Mail, 36 megabytes, I'm gonna remove. Services, computer browser, I'm gonna keep. DHCP, I'm gonna keep. Diagnostics, this diagnostics I'm gonna keep, otherwise you cannot need it for includes this diagnostics, memory diagnostics, a resource. Let me see. I think we can remove it. I can't remember, this is a long time ago. Where were we? Yeah, diagnostics. I think we can remove it. Distributed link tracking client, I'm gonna keep. DNS client, error reporting, no, I don't want that. Not gonna bother Microsoft with my creation. We're gonna keep this. Interactive surface detection, I'm gonna keep that. IP helper, I'm gonna keep it. Network access protection agent, gonna keep that. This I'm gonna keep. Offline files, by using offline files you can manage user data more efficiently while and changing users access to their files and folders will not connected to the network while not connected to the network. Yeah, we don't need this one. Protected storage, I would keep that. Quality Windows video experience, I would keep that. Remote access auto connection manager, surface maps and maintains network addresses to connection destinations. If you are not connected to a network and a program cannot reach a remote address. Okay, now we're gonna keep that. Remote access manager, was that remote registry? These are all small files, eh? In fact, we don't have to worry too much about. Wait a minute, I saw a big one there. No, so all small files. What is this? Test scheduler, needed for the... No, 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 I'm not gonna do that. I want to defragment my drivers. I want to be able to use these tools. You know, some guys remove these things and then you have a crippled system. Follow volume shadow copy. System is to... No, I'm gonna keep that. No, I'm just looking at the sizes. Implementation of a column. You don't have to understand everything, eh? You don't have to understand each and everything. Certain things that you don't understand, you can also not select. Simpler and more secure way to configure network devices and computers, in addition to easier device network settings, to a USB flash drive. And then put the drive into device, blah blah blah. Needed for file printer sharing and media center. Yeah. I don't need that one. Windows event enables application to publish, access, and process events. Events are stored in events logs. Remote access parental. Yo, we don't gonna use that, man. Come on. We don't need that. Windows remote management, we don't need. Windows search, yeah, Windows search. This will remove the part of Windows search, the surface which indexes files in the background. With this remove, your searcher, your searching amounts large numbers of files may be slower, but in general, this component takes a lot of resources. Okay, so let's kill it. Windows time, let's keep the Windows time. System 16-bit support, would you like to remove that? I don't see no reason to remove it. What is this? BitLocker drive encryption, I'm gonna keep. Cache dump support, I'm gonna keep. Digital write managers, I'm gonna keep. Disk quota. Help. Oh my gosh. 175 megabytes. Let's remove that. Built-in disk burn support, we're gonna keep. We're gonna keep this. Manual install. So, this is what you must understand. You can create two sorts of DVD or ISO files. If we're gonna remove this and we're gonna, for instance, boot the CD to the desktop, then we cannot, let me say differently. There will be no setup file, you know? Sometimes you just put the installer DVD or CD in your CD-ROM and then you can start the installing. Right? That will not be possible if we're gonna remove the manual install setup, the setup exe. Then we're gonna have a system that will not be able to install from there. You will only be able to boot from it. Yeah? I think it's kinda ridiculous to start the setup in an existing, yeah, that is nice maybe for upgrading, but yeah, I don't think you're gonna use this for upgrading, right? So I'm gonna remove it, but you could keep it, okay? Depending on what kind of system you're creating. Natural language, what is that? Well, natural language is something that effect you can remove. It's very big, used for extra, let's go back. Where was it? Used for extra functionalities in speech and search. Basically, it provides the ability to use speech and search more naturally. Almost like addressing another person. Do you want this system to talk? Nah. Do you want parental controls? Nah. Reliability performance monitor, only 5 megabytes. We're going to keep this remote differential compression, run legacy CPL. I'm just keeping this all. Eh? What is this? 9 megabyte makes Vista compatible. Makes Vista compatible with all the Windows control panel plugins. This component may be exploited to bypass UAC, so removing it might even raise security. Yeah? Might even raise security unless you need this to run your CPL. Okay, then we're gonna remove it if it raises security. Security Center. Windows Security Center indicates whether key security compatible. I can never say that word. Are turned on and up to date. Windows Security Center notifies you if updates are required or if you must take additional steps to help make your computer secure. Let's just keep Security Center, okay? Software quality management, I'm not gonna remove that. This is only 07 megabytes. This is 1.5. This is 5 megabytes. Sync Center gives you the place where you can, place where you can manage data synchronization in several scenarios between multiple PCs, between network servers and PCs, and with the devices you connect to your PC. I'm gonna keep this. System Restore, I'm gonna keep it as well. Tablet PC is 391 megabytes. What do you think we should do with that? I think we're gonna remove it. User account control, UAC, I'm gonna keep that. We hated this way back in Vista, but I'm gonna keep it. Windows Defender, yeah. In fact, you can keep it, but note. The shortcut manage startup performance won't work. Use msconfig instead. Okay. Helps protect your computer against pop-ups, slow performance, and security threats caused by spyware. You know, let's just keep. Well, on the other hand, this thing is outdated. Windows Easy Transfer. Let's remove this. Easy Transfer. What is that? Windows Easy Transfer is a quick and easy way for users to transfer their files and settings from their old computer. We're not gonna use this. Okay, Windows Picture and Fax Viewer, I'm gonna keep that. And zip folders, of course, we're gonna keep. Okay, now we're gonna go to tweaks. Yes, uncheck it. Yes. It's because I selected System Restore. Okay, we fixed that. You see that? We got some pop-ups and then we could fix whatever we did not do right. Okay? System. Autoplay enabled. Memory requirement. We set it to 256 megabytes. Okay, the rest we leave. Default security. User account control on. System. Autoplay, paging, power sync. Yeah, that's good. Explorer. Control. Panel, classic view. Enabled. Show extensions for known file types, show hidden files, yes. So we can clean up our temp folders that we find in our account. Internet Explorer. Ugh, we're not gonna use this anymore. Surfaces. up here you can set up some services, but I'm not gonna go there. Unattended. Here you can insert your product key that I'm not gonna do. Okay. We're not gonna touch any of this. Okay. Don't go play smart and do things in here. Don't touch this. All right. Don't touch this. Yeah. So we have everything now. And now we're gonna say apply. And now we can say rebuild one. Rebuild all. Let's see the difference. This method will rebuild and save only the selected Windows version, thus making the image a lot smaller. Rebuild all. This method will rebuild and save all the versions, thus making it smaller than just saving changes, but bigger than rebuild one. This is the slowest method. Use only if you need to save all the versions in the image. Okay, so what it's saying here is that if you're gonna say rebuild all, as you could see, we could choose what we wanted to create, right? And we choose for professional. But if we're gonna choose rebuild all, it's also gonna rebuild the home. Then you can, whenever you're gonna start that CD. Let me see. This, if you need to save all the versions in the image, even the unchanged ones, and reduce size. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go for rebuild one. Yeah. This is recommended. That's it, okay. So there we go. And now this system is gonna work. Okay, it will do certain things. I'm gonna just show you the process. This is a fast computer, so it shouldn't take too long. It's removing all the parts. And soon we're also gonna see how big. I think it's gonna be bigger than 699 megabytes, because I did not remove essential parts that I think are important for the system. As I told you, most of the times you end up with a crippled system, and I don't want this system to become a crippled system. I want to be able to use it, but just have a lighter installer and also a system with less services to run. It's just like Android. You see, and up here you can see the priority. You can set the priority to high, but I'm just gonna leave it this way because it's doing it pretty good. It's applying the changes now. And really, I love this software so much, because thanks to this software was one of the first software packages that let me create my own installer. I was like, at that time, like, wow, was the most fantastic thing to do. But as you can see, we are still using this technology. We can still use it in 2018. In fact, I could have gone for the latest version of NT-Lite, but in fact, yeah, I went for this one. I have my reasons. Certain software will never ever be created anymore. This is one of them. It's very, very good software. This was amazing software about 2006 up to 2008 copyright. You see that? It's saving the changes, and there we go. It's rebuilding the image. Now you're gonna see the size of the image, how big it's gonna become. It might become something like 800-900 megabytes, the way it looks now to me. It will not fit on the CD. We can forget about it. It will be maybe even 1200 megabytes. And when this is done, you can go ahead and burn a CD or a DVD from the image. You see that? This image will be bigger than, it will be greater than 1200, maybe even 1400 megabytes. Oh boy, this thing is gonna be big. But we removed lots of stuff out of it. The essential things we removed. But it's still very big, what I see here. 1000 megabytes, see that? It's an effect you cannot predict. The way it looks is gonna be greater than 2 gigabytes. I don't believe it. No, it's about 1200 megabytes. Just what I thought. This is just the finalizing part. It's finishing the DVD, the ISO. Hello. Yes. Okay, that is nice. Thank you. Very nice of you. This is a long video. I love the new Camtasia, at least Camtasia 9. Love it. It's working really nice. And I think we are done. So now we're gonna go to next, and now we're gonna say create an image, and here device, burn speed, we're gonna call it Windows 7 Pro Lite. Yeah, and then you can also say split, but we're not gonna split. So you could create, we could create 2 CDs from this. You see that? And then you get 2 CDs, part 1 and part 2. This is very, very smart software. Okay, let's make an ISO. Gonna save the ISO, the ISO to my documents, and we're gonna call it Windows 7 Pro Lite 2018. Damn, what's up with this one? Lite. Okay, and there we go. And it's gonna create the ISO, and the ISO is 1324 megabytes. I know guys that created 699 versions. I think that was from the SP1, and I think my version is SP2. I think SP2 is already inside. I'm not even sure. But it's still, let me see how big was the official ISO was. ...2500 megabytes, and we brought it down to 1300 megabytes. Okay, and there it is. It's done. It's in my documents. You see that? Windows 7 Pro Lite, 1300 megabytes. Very nice and light. Well, it's not so light that you can install it on a CD, but it will be more functional than the ones that you can install on a CD. Those will have, yeah, no common sense, really. You will not like that system because it's just not good. So now we can close the system, exit. Yeah, here it is. And well, this is how to create your Windows 7 Lite installer. If you want to see the result, make sure to check my video after this one, okay? Because I'm gonna edit this video real fast, and then we're gonna create a new video, and then we're gonna install it in some virtual machine and yeah, see if it actually installs and if it's any good. Until then, if you like this video, of course, don't forget to leave it a like and to subscribe to my channel, but only if you're gonna hit the notifying bell, because then it makes sense. In no other way it makes any sense to subscribe. Thanks again. Until the next video, part 2.